Well, that would have been when I entered graduate school at Duke. And I must say, I wasn't really intimidated. I really didn't know what I was getting myself into, to tell you the truth. But it really worked for me. It really did, I have to say that. I don't know, maybe it was because I had the right personality or something. But in any case, I selected my thesis advisor. And he was a very volatile person. Ah, he was very volatile. Not attacking me, but that was just his personality. And I thought, gee. And I was new to this environment at Duke, and I thought, gee, I'm just not going to be able to hang with him. I'm not going to be able to get a degree under him. And when I applied there as a master's student. And I thought, well, the worst thing that can happen is I don't end up staying here, but I'm going to change. I'm going to change advisors. I'm just not going to let him wipe me out. It's the worst thing that can happen. I leave the school, and I don't stay, but I'm going to change advisors. So I went to this other professor who was there. I said, now the smart thing to do is to pick someone who is very confident in himself. Not me, but confident in himself. And that's the type of person I need. I don't need someone who is elite, has no confidence in himself, like this guy who was so volatile. So I picked a guy. I went and told the chairman of the department that I was going to switch labs. And he said, oh, no, don't switch. He said, just give him a few more months. I said, okay. So I went. I left his office, and I was really afraid of what he was going to say, but I switched. I went to the professor to whom I'd already approached about letting me transfer to his lab. He said, sure, come right on in. So then I had to go and tell the professor that I was leaving. And he said, oh, they're going to say I'm... Because I was first African-American there, of course they were going to say, he thought that they were going to say that he was a racist. I said, well, you can be sure that I'm never going to go out and tell anyone that you were racist. I said, but your personality is just too strong for me. So I switched. And now I had to worry about what the chairman of the department was going to say. And he pretended he never knew. So it ended out pretty well. So I lucked out on that one. I think it had to do with the fact that I soothed the personality that needed to be soothed. That was the guy who thought he was going to be called a racist. And I knew that I had a guy where I was going to go. I knew that he was self-confident. He would handle the guy who was not so confident in himself. He would handle him just fine. And that's just the way it worked out. So... I thought that was pretty clever on my part.